Good evening, everyone. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Michael Cogdell. Tonight, we keep getting new looks at the damage caused by those storms on Sunday.
In Belton, trees fell on homes and power lines were down. News 4's Mandy Gaither is there with a look at the damage.
You can see the power of this storm all around me. This is what used to be a mailbox. It was crushed by debris. We found it on the ground. And behind me, this is a large oak tree, which obviously was ripped out of the ground because of the wind. It did not hit a home, but other houses weren't so lucky. It lasted only a matter of moments, but the effects of Monday morning's storm will be felt for a long time in Belton.
It hit the house so hard that it actually hit our china cabinet and knocked some dishes off the china cabinet.
At Wesley Sumner's 130-year-old home, an oak tree caused all this damage, falling just feet from his daughter's bedroom.
It's kind of obliterated her ceiling and everything up in there as it kind of crashed and fell down the house. And we're just thankful that she wasn't here.
The family car didn't fare well either, crushed by the same tree during the powerful storm.
I got right into my hallway, and it was like you could feel just the whole pressure hit the house, and it was just woo.
A few houses down, another home had a large limb fall through it. The owner here said she had just replaced her roof in April. Crews had to use cranes to dismantle it. Damage also done to the well-known furniture store Maynard's. Sky 4 shows repairs underway. The awning ripped off the front of the building, debris scattered around. On Carroll Lane, up to 7 trees fell around this house. Greg Elgin's roof is patched up now, but has at least $9,000 in damage.
I jerked my little girl out of the bed and into the closet, and my wife got my little boy and got him into the closet. We were just worried about trees falling on the house.
Crews will continue to work to clear the debris and cut down damaged trees, which are scattered all over Belton. Duke Energy says that power is back on to most of the homes in our viewing area, but here in Belton, they're still working in some areas. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4 in Belton.